Dr. Mohamed Odier is going to talk about alkyl ether sulfonates for enhanced oil recovery in high salinity reservoir. Evidence for dual anionic, non-ionic solubilization behavior. He is from Professor at Sultan Qaboos University, College of Science, and he has a PhD degree in physical chemistry, University of Texas at Austin, and MS degree from University of Algiers, and then BS degree in physical science, University of Algiers. From 1999 to present, Professor of Chemistry in Sultan Qaboos University, 84 to 87, Associate Professor, University of Lida, Algiers, 85 to 86. He was on Fulbright Fellowship to University of Texas at Austin, and 82 to 84, Algerian National Petroleum Company, Research and Development Group Leader. He won Best Research Award at Sultan Qaboos University College of Science, and also Professor of Fellowship from Bowling Green State University in Ohio in 2001, and awarded a Professor of Fellowship in Chemistry Department, University of Texas at Austin. Please.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. We might talk to them today about steel in the EOR business. For this, I have to thank Mr. Halabi, Dr. Halabi. Is my talk which fit nicely in his presentation. I think you now know something about surfactants. And I will focus then in one aspect of EOR, in one chemical only, although sometimes or many times in EOR use a combination of all of these chemicals. I will focus today only on surfactants, and basically on one type of surfactant, which is called alkyl ether sulfonate. Those are anionic surfactants, negatively charged. They are now being used in EOR since many 15 years ago, just because of their high tolerance to salinity and high temperatures. But so I should add also that the EOR, the big challenge EOR, is when you have high salinity, high hardness, calcium, magnesium concentration in the reservoir brine, and also the temperature, if you have high temperature. So for this reason, these alkyl ether sulfonates are being used, but the thing about this, they are alkaline, and they are used as non-anionic surfactants, although in fact we will show that they don't behave like anionics. Then you have to be very careful when you use them for EOR formulations.